Namaste. This practice is to explore breathwork. In Sanskrit, the word prana means life force, and pranayama is the practice of controlling the breath or the life force. So you'll want to find a comfortable seat. You can sit cross-legged, or you can sit on your heels. You can sit on a cushion. I have a little pillow that I'm sitting on. You want to find a place where you can sit comfortably for 10 minutes or so. And of course, you can adjust if you need to. So once you get settled, take a few breaths and feel the connection of your sit bones to the support beneath you. You can imagine roots growing out of your tailbone down into the earth, grounding you, reaching all the way down. And imagine energy from the core center of the earth is coming up through your roots and nourishing all the energy pathways, the nerve bundles running up and down your spine. And all the while, your eyes can be closed or at a soft gaze. Now we'll reach the arms into the air and use the reach of your arms to facilitate the lifting of your spine. And you're rotating your triceps forward. And this external rotation of the upper arm, it creates a spreading in the collarbones, so we have more space in the sides of the neck. And simultaneously, as you stretch your arms to lift your spine, can you soften your shoulder blades down your back? Now keep this lifting in the spine and then bend your elbows out to the side to broaden across your chest. And then keep that opening and bring your palms to touch. Connect your thumbs with the base of your sternum and lift your sternum towards your chin with the head slightly bowed. Press your palms right to left, left to right, and spread your fingers forward. And imagine that the swirling thoughts in your head are like sand that has been stirred up in stormy waters. And now the water is calm. So the sand is allowed to settle back down to the bottom of the ocean. And the ocean floor in the heart center. All the thoughts settling down into heart center. Any sense of antsy or stagnant energy feels like it's being smoothed out by each inhale and exhale. Keep this inward connection, observing your breath, and just release your palms down to your mid-thigh. Wrapping your palms around the contour of the thigh. And gently press the flesh of your thigh towards your knee to help lift your chest. Keep your head slightly bowed, chest lifted, shoulders back. And feel your breath filling the upper chest as if you were inflating balloons beneath your collarbones. Even when you exhale, the chest is allowed to remain open and lifted with the support of your palms pressing in the thighs. Now imagine you're looking with the back of your eyes down into the heart. And you're observing the flow of your breath here. All of your senses are drawing inward, like a turtle pulling into her shell. Your senses are riding the wave of each breath, traveling deeper and deeper inward. Tuning in to the sound of the breath as it flows in and out of your nostrils. Perhaps noticing the subtle cooling quality of the inhale breath as it comes in. And the subtle warming quality of the exhale as it flows out. And then we'll begin to activate the Ujjayi breath. Ujjayi means victory. With this breath, we'll begin to elongate the inhale and exhale. So to connect with this technique, first we'll continue to inhale through the nose, and then we'll exhale out of the mouth in a whispered, and it's like you're fogging up a window with your breath, and the window's right in front of your mouth. Just like that, once more. Now you'll keep that same exhaling action, but with your lips together so the breath flows out of the nose. And so the effect is like you're creating a cave in the back of your throat, and the breath becomes like wind in a cave. Because there's a slight lifting of the soft palate, and it's creating a little constriction in the back of the throat. And so the breath will start to sound like ocean waves. So this is the Ujjayi breath, breathing in and out of the nose with that lifting of the soft palate. And this little constriction allows us to elongate the inhale and the exhale. So thus there's more control of the prana, of the breath. And so with this Ujjayi breath, let's practice a calming technique. So with this breath, we'll elongate the exhale. So you'll count the length of your inhale and then see if you can exhale for twice the length of the inhale. So if you're inhaling Om 1, Om 2, Om 3, and then exhaling 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Inhaling Om 1, Om 2, Om 3. And exhaling 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can go at your own pace, maintaining a steady rhythm with the elongated exhale. Continue to connect with the sound of the breath as you count. Visualize the flow of the breath up and down your spine. If at any moment you feel like you're creating tension around the control of the breath, pause and take a few normal breaths without any effort or control, and then return to your count and your elongated exhale. Practicing being gentle and patient, and just objectively observing whatever arises as you breathe and count. May notice you naturally begin to linger in the pause before the next inhale or exhale, and let that happen. If it doesn't come naturally, that's fine, but if your body does want to just float in that spaciousness at the top of the inhale and the bottom of the exhale, let it happen. Take one more cycle of inhale and exhale at your pace. Return to normal breathing. And you may want to adjust your position. You can cross your legs the opposite way, or you can change your position entirely to come and sit on your heels, whatever you prefer, whatever you need to remain sitting tall, comfortable enough that you can focus on the breath and not be too distracted by the physical body. So reassert the lifting of your spine with the lifting of your arms. Take a nice deep inhale, filling beneath your collarbones. Keep that lift. Exhale, bend your elbows out to the side. And then just rest your palms on your thighs. Press the thighs toward the knees to help lift your chest. Good. So now we'll practice a three-part breath, imagining your lungs exist in three compartments, in the belly and in the ribs and then in the upper chest. And the breath is like water. We're pouring the water into our vessel, filling from bottom to top. And we'll pause after each compartment is filled. So exhale all the air out. Now inhale a third of the way in, fill your belly, pause. Inhale another third, fill the ribs, pause. Inhale the rest of the way, fill your chest, pause. And then exhale, release chest, ribs. Gently pull the navel toward the spine to press the air out. Take a normal breath in. And a normal breath out. Normal breath in. And exhale all the air out. We'll go again, three-part breath. Inhale, fill the belly, a third of the way, pause. pause. Inhale, fill the ribs, pause. Inhale, fill the rest of the way up into the chest, pause. And then exhale, release chest, ribs, belly. Normal breath in and normal breath out. Normal breath in, normal breath out. One more breath in, and then exhale all the air out. Three-part breath, inhale, fill the belly, pause. Inhale, fill the ribs, pause. Inhale, fill the chest, pause. And exhale, release chest, ribs, belly. Normal breathing. Just notice how you feel without judgment. Just observe. Knowing that we are increasing our lung capacity just by breathing deeply and mindfully here. So now we'll again do the three-part breath, but this time we'll do a fluid inhale, and then we'll stair-step the exhale breath. So signal to yourself that you're ready to begin. When you're ready, with a nice long exhale, all the air out. And then smooth breath, inhale, fill the belly, ribs, and chest, pause, and then release a third of the breath from the chest, pause. Release a third of the breath from the ribs, pause. And then release the belly by pulling the navel toward the spine to press out any stale air, pause. And then normal breath in and normal breath out. Normal breath in through the nose and normal breath out through the nose. Normal breath in. Exhale all the air out. And then picture the lungs in three compartments, but inhale in a smooth way. Feel the belly, the ribs, and the chest, and then pause at the top. And then exhale a third of the way, release the chest, pause. Exhale a third of the way, release the ribs, pause. Exhale all the air out, pull the navel toward the spine. And then normal breath in and normal breath out. Normal breath in and normal breath out. And normal breathing. Just notice how you feel. So now that we've expanded our lung capacity, let's do alternate nostril breathing to help balance the hemispheres from left to right, right to left. If you need to adjust your position, you may want to stretch your legs out for a moment. You can twist a little side to side. You can remain in a peaceful seated position, but if you're feeling antsy, you can also do a little side to side, stretch your side body. You can release your neck. Anything you need to allow yourself to recenter and reground. So alternate nostril breathing. We'll do the energizing version, where we'll involve our whole arm movement. And you're going to use your peace fingers on both hands to block off the nostrils. So we'll start off blocking off the right. I'll mirror you. And you'll inhale through the left. Retain your breath as you switch your arms and exhale through the right. Inhale through the right. Retain your breath, switch, and exhale left. Inhale left. Retain your breath, switch, exhale right. Inhale right. Retain and switch, exhale left. Inhale left. Retain and switch, exhale right. Inhale right. And switch, exhale left. Keep going, inhale. And switch, exhale. Inhale. And switch, exhale. Full round again, inhale. And switch, exhale right. Again, inhale. And switch, exhale left. Once more, inhale. And switch, and you'll finish off exhaling right. And then palms face up. Close your eyes and turn your eyeballs toward the center of your forehead at the third eye. And while you do this, engage the muscles of your pelvic floor. So the same muscles used to stop the flow of urine, engage those. It's almost like we're putting a cork in an upside down bottle. So you're keeping the energy plugged in, flowing up your spine, directed with your gaze to the prefrontal cortex, the more highly evolved part of our brain where we connect to our innate wisdom and intuition. Neurologically turning on that center and all this energy generated through our pranayama practice is being brought into this intuitive place of innate intelligence. Cosmic wisdom. Inwardly recite the sound of Om. 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 The universal sound of creativity, the primordial vibration. Om. Stay here and just observe your breath. If you're feeling tired, you can lie down in Shavasana. But if you're feeling sturdy and strong in your spine, remain seated. For as long as you like. Knowing that this practice has opened up pathways and channels for you to access your vitality, infusing every cell of your being with this inner fire.